Hello everyone. This demo video will show you how to draw boxes in two-point perspective. You will need paper, a red pencil, a graphite pencil, eraser, straight edge like a ruler, T-square, and drafting triangles. As always, try to draw with a light hand and be as precise as you can, and keep your pencils as sharp as you possibly can, or consider using a mechanical pencil like I'm using here. Every time we start a perspective drawing, we need to establish our horizon line first, which I mark HL, our center of vision second, which I mark CV, and two vanishing points, which I mark VP. Since this is a two-point perspective drawing, I will place the two vanishing points on the horizon line and label them. One to the left, the center of vision, is the LVP. The one to the right is the RVP. All the boxes drawn today will need to be done between these two vanishing points. I'm going to start my boxes by drawing a base plane. First, the front corner is connected to the two vanishing points. Then, I add points that will help me draw the back edges. These points are connected to the opposite vanishing point, so the left corner is connected to the right vanishing point, and the right corner is connected to the left vanishing point. From each of these points, I draw vertical transversals that will represent the height of my box. I'm going to determine the height of this box on the front edge by putting a point on that front transversal. I then connect that point to the left and right vanishing points, just like I did when I drew the base. Where they intersect the back left and back right transversals, I get two new top corners. I then follow the same technique of connecting across the opposite sides to the other vanishing points to complete the box. If I've been careful with these new lines, they should intersect at the same point on that furthest transversal or back edge of the box. Once I'm completed, I switch to my graphite pencil and draw the object lines, which are the lines that you can see if you are the viewer. The back edges of those boxes are hidden by the front planes of the box, so I don't bother drawing those. Also, since this box is located below the horizon line, I need to make sure that I include the lines that represent that back edge of the top of the box, because I can see down onto the top of the box. I will now locate a new box that straddles the horizon line. This box is going to be started by drawing the front elevation edge instead of the base. At the top and bottom of this line, I connect it to both vanishing points. Make sure to not draw it to the center of vision. I can decide where to locate the back edges by connecting each of those parallel orthogonal lines with a vertical transversal, so I'm just choosing anywhere along those two lines. Now I just follow the process of connecting the new top and bottom corners to their opposite vanishing points, and when they intersect, I get the back edge. This is an alternative way to building a box without drawing the base first. And as always, I will finish it off by drawing the box's object lines in graphite. Notice that as I complete it, we do not see the top nor do we see the bottom of this box because it straddles the horizon line. Both the bottom and top are hidden from our view. We only get to see the left and right front planes. For the third box, I'll use the same technique as I did with the first. With this box being completely above the horizon line, the observer will get a view of the bottom of the box. That is how you draw a box in two-point perspective. I hope you found these videos useful, and thanks for watching.